This is an original 1956 one-sheet poster for Godzilla, King of the Monsters, an American-Japanese production based on the original Godzilla of 1954. This poster was all ripped up among the folds, had paper missing, and needed borders added. We did all that restoration on a linen backing at PosterFix.
Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to PosterFix Studio. Today we have a very interesting one-sheet poster for the movie Godzilla. Before we get started on this project, though, I want to tell you that if you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, get in touch with me, tell me their size, tell me their condition, and send me a few pictures, and I'll get back to you with an estimate of what it will cost to restore them. I look forward to seeing your posters. Now let's see what's going on with this rare Godzilla poster.
When we got this US one-sheet poster for Godzilla, it was broken and torn, as you can see. It's actually broken all along the fold lines. It's only being held together with tape, and I'm going to have to go around and remove the tape from the face of the poster. And once I do that, it'll be in many pieces. Before I linen back it, however, I need to stretch a screen with cotton canvas. This cotton canvas is made in the United States, and it is a flawless canvas. That is to say, it has no bumps and bruises or broken areas. It gives a very nice linen backing to a vintage poster. And linen backing is when we take your vintage poster and mount it to a piece of acid-free paper and cotton canvas. You're going to see how we do that today.
Okay, the screen is stretched with cotton canvas, and now we've got to mount the acid-free paper to this screen.
The first thing I'm going to do is roll out my paper on the table and take wheat paste and cover the paper thoroughly with this wheat paste, which also has an acid buffer added to it to make sure that there is no spread of acid within the paper. I lift it up and I put it on the screen of canvas, which I have just stretched. This paper is wet with wheat paste, and it's not easy to handle wet paper, but after 36 years of restoring vintage posters, I think I've gotten quite good at it. This movie poster dates from 1956. The colors are very good. It's not faded. The only problem with it is that it's been used many times and it's broken up along the folds, and there's many pieces of paper missing throughout the poster. Now that I have the paper on the canvas, I need to roll it out to make sure it's stretched out and even all around. Push out the excess air pockets and excess wheat paste to make sure that it's good and flat. Now I'm taking my knife and I'm cutting off the excess paper around the edges to make sure that there's a good lip in there so that the paper hugs the canvas on the outer perimeter of the screen. And now the screen is ready to have the Godzilla poster mounted to it, which you will see after this commercial break, so don't go away. We're back in the PosterFix shop. The screen is ready for this Godzilla poster to be mounted to it. It is in very poor condition with breaks along the folds, and there is some tape on the face of the poster. And I've already put other posters, including this Japanese Godzilla poster, which looks like a stained glass window, as well as this poster with Burt Lancaster. I'm beginning by putting the poster down. It's still got some tape on it, however, and the tape has to be removed. But I haven't really discovered how much tape there is. Ah, there it is. So I'm taking more of the tape off, making sure the back of it is good and clean, and after that I will make effort to take the tape off the front. I'm going to be applying the wheat paste directly to the acid-free paper and not to the poster. I'll let the poster sit on the acid-free paper with the wheat paste there, and it will absorb the wheat paste. I'm using some chemicals to get this tape off the face of the poster so that we don't lose any of the image. Ah, There, I got a nick there, but we will touch that up, or we will put in that piece. I'm applying wheat paste directly to the acid-free paper. Godzilla, King of the Monsters, is a 1956 kaiju film directed by Terry O. Morse and Ishiro Honda. It is a heavily re-edited American localization, or Americanization, of the 1954 Japanese film Godzilla. The film was a Japanese-American co-production with the original footage produced by Toho Films and the new footage produced by Jewel Enterprises. And in this version, it stars Raymond Burr. In 1955, Edmund Goldman acquired the 1954 film from Toho to produce a revised version for American audiences. This version dubbed most of the Japanese dialogue into English, altered and removed key plot points and themes, and added new footage with Raymond Burr narrating most of the film and interacting with body doubles and Japanese-American actors in an attempt to make it seem like Raymond Burr was part of the original Japanese production. Godzilla, King of Monsters, was theatrically released in the United States on April 27, 1956, and was followed by an international release. The film was responsible for introducing Godzilla to a worldwide audience, as the 1954 film remained unavailable officially overseas until 2004. In 1955, Edmund Goldman approached Toho International Incorporated, which was a Los Angeles-based subsidiary created to distribute Toho films overseas, about purchasing the rights to Godzilla. Toho had shown Goldman advertisement materials which interested him in a screening of the film. Goldman then made Toho an offer of $25,000, which they accepted immediately. The contract was forged on September 27, 1955. The contract stipulated that Toho and Goldman agreed that the film would be narrated, dubbed in English, and completed by the revisions, additions, and deletions, with final approval by Toho. Paul Schriebmann assisted in the film's acquisition. Samuel Arkoff of American International Pictures also made a bid for the film, negotiating with Toho for 3 months until he discovered the rights were already sold to Goldman. Goldman enlisted the help of Harold Ross and Richard Kay of Jewel Enterprises to distribute the film. According to Goldman, Ross and Kay's idea was to dub the film and hire Raymond Burr. Goldman would later sell his interest to Jewel Enterprises. Ross and Kay turned to Joseph E. Levine to further finance the project. The duo arranged a screening of the film for Levine in Los Angeles. The film's possibilities excited Levine and paid $100,000 for half of the rights. This arrangement allowed the rights to Godzilla to be split between Jewel Enterprises and Levine's Embassy Pictures. Levine enlisted Edward Barrison to create Trans World Releasing Corporation to distribute the film. Levine also enlisted producer Terry Turner to develop promotional strategies, which cost $400,000. Turner managed to get the film mentioned by Steve Allen on The Tonight Show. Levine and Turner initially considered the title Godzilla, the Sea Beast, but eventually settled on Godzilla, King of the Monsters. Ross and Kay hired Terry Morse to direct the film. Schriebmann had arranged for Burr to participate in the film. Morse was paid $10,000 for rewriting and directing the film, and Burr was paid the same amount for a single day's work. Godzilla, King of the Monsters opened on April 4th, 1956 in Lowe's State Theater in New York City. It was theatrically released in the United States on April 27, 1956, to 283 theaters as a double feature with Prehistoric Woman. The film earned more than $2 million in rentals during its initial theatrical run. The film earned a $200,000 profit for its producers. The TV rights were sold to RKO, and it made its television broadcast debut in 1959 on KHJ-TV in Los Angeles. The film was theatrically released in Japan on May 29, 1957 as Kaiju o Gojira, Monster King Godzilla, to a positive reception from Japanese audiences, with the English dialogue subtitled in Japanese and the film cropped in Toho Pan scope. I'm using a sponge to clean off the wheat paste from the face of the poster.
You've got Godzilla linen bags. Now we've got to put in the restoration time, which means putting in new borders, like the old natural borders, and then do paper fills of other kinds in the image, like here and there, and then touch it up.
It was the first Japanese feature to become a commercial success in the United States, and was, at the time, the fourth foreign film to have grossed more than $1 million at an American box office. Goldman originally acquired the film to distribute in the American and Canadian markets. Due to the film's commercial success, however, foreign distributors became interested in acquiring the American cut. Trans World, therefore, renegotiated with Toho to license the American version to foreign markets. The film was released in France on February 14, 1957, where it became the 79th top-grossing film of 1957.
We're going to let this screen dry for a few days before we commence with the restoration. Don't go away. We'll be right back. Yeah, it's not even. I just mounted it the way it was.
Well, we're back in the PosterFix shop, and my wife, Oki, is going to go in there and analyze this job. What she needs to do is take paper as well as paper pulp to do the paper fills. The paper pulp will be used in the holes and the edge bits that are missing, but we're going to use real paper to create the borders around the outside of the poster so we can bring it back to its original dimensions, the way it was seen when it was first printed in 1956. Oki is taking acid-free newsprint paper, a paper that roughly matches the weight of the paper of the original poster, and she is cutting pieces that she has already measured out to act as border pieces. And the reason why these pieces are the size that they are is so that they coincide with the fold marks and breaks that are already in the poster. Gathering the paper up and going back to the work table. Oki and I have been restoring vintage posters for many, many, many years. I started doing it 36 years ago, and she joined me in 2002 when we got married in Korea. There is a Korean version of Godzilla known as Yonggari. And I've seen the original Korean film, Yonggari, made in the 1960s, that represents Korea, or South Korea, as a very modern nation, probably more modern than it really was at the time. There has also been a remake of Yonggari made recently, which was made in the 1960s, and is quite good. She's using methyl cellulose as the glue to piece in these pieces of paper. And these pieces are expanding. She's getting them wet with paper to help them expand more and to help the glue to spread better. This glue also has an acid-free as well as a fungicide added to it to prevent both acid and bacteria and mold from eating away at the paper. Well, now Oki has completed all the paper fills, both from paper pulp and the addition of the borders. And the poster has dried, and I'm going to cut it down. After this poster's trimmed, you're going to see Oki do the retouching of the color. So, you will see that after this commercial break, so don't go away.
Today, this poster is going to get a restoration. It's going to get the paper fills touched up, like that area where it says Raymond Burr, and this area, and that area. I don't know how much of this I'm going to show because I have so much other work to do. I don't really have time to photograph everything.
Well, Oki has discovered an air pocket in the poster, so she's put some glue under that air pocket and is now putting weights on top of it so that it dries nice and flat as she readies herself to do the color in painting and retouching of this American Godzilla poster from 1956. Now that she has the poster in front of her and it's easier to handle, she's going to take paper pulp and go over it again and make sure she's got all the little cracks and creases filled in where they need to be filled in. We're almost done. After this commercial break, you will see the completion of this Godzilla poster from 1956. So don't go away. And now the poster gets trimmed down where I leave a 1-inch extra backing border around it.
That about wraps it up for today's edition of PosterFix Studio. I appreciate your joining me. And remember, at PosterFix, we bring your vintage posters back to life.